Hello everyone, how are you all doing? In today's video, we shall be learning about the structure and function of mammary glands, which is also called as breast. So before going to the structure of a mammary gland, we shall discuss about its location. Where exactly the mammary glands are present in case of humans? Okay, so in case of humans, the mammary glands are located in the thoracic region. Whereas if we consider cows or buffaloes, it is present in the abdominal region. Okay, in case of rats, it is present in both abdominal and thoracic region. So in case of humans, it is present in the thoracic regions and they are paired structures, which is made up of glandular as well as a fatty tissue. Okay, yes, we will discuss about its structure in detail going forward. So in case of males, the coming to its activation in different genders like males and females, right? In males, it is rudimentary or we call it inactive. Okay, see, the mammary glands are present both in males and females, but in case of females, it is active. In case of males, it is inactive. We also call it as rudimentary. Right? So coming to the function, the main function of the mammary gland, right, is to secrete milk in order to nourish the newly born kid. So the main function of the mammary gland is to secrete milk. Right? Coming to its location, it is in the thoracic region. In males, it is inactive and in females, it is active. Right? Well, so now let us discuss about the structure of a mammary gland. Okay, so I have represented the sectional wave diagrammatically, okay, of the breast or the mammary gland. So here are the parts of it. Like the mammary gland consists of mammary lobes. Okay, in each breast there are almost 15 to 20 mammary lobes are present, okay, in each breast. And then it is compromised of mammary alveolus, or you can call it as, this is singular, so the plural will be alveoli. And it is made up of mammary ducts, mammary tubules, ampulla, lactiferous duct, nipple, areola and fatty tissue. Yes, so now let us understand these parts with the help of this diagram. Right? Yeah. Here you can see whatever I have marked in the red color are the rib bones. Okay. And the muscles which are connecting these ribs are, of course, the muscles which are present in between the two ribs, you call them as intercostal muscles. And the one which I have marked in blue color represents the pectoralis muscle. So the breast or the mammary gland is situated, is located on top of this pectoralis muscle. Okay. And then you can see whatever I have marked in the green color represents you the mammary lobes, which I told you that it will be present like to 15 to 20 mammary lobes are present in each breast. Okay. And this is what the mammary tubules looks like. And this is what the mammary duct, right? Many mammary tubules will connect to form a mammary duct. Okay, and this is the expanded part, what we call it as a ampulla, and this is what the lactiferous duct, again the narrow tubule, and then it leads to a nipple. Okay, see, coming to its function, we'll understand in detail. I told you that there are 15 to 20 mammary lobes present in each breast. So inside mammary breast, right, you can see there are so many mammary alveolus, right? So something like this, you have so many mammary alveolus, right? I'm considering one mammary lobe, okay? Like this, you will be having so many mammary alveoli inside one lobe, one mammary lobe. Inside one mammary lobe, you'll be having so many mammary alveolus. And so many mammary alveolus, right, will be connecting to this mammary duct. So this is the mammary duct. Many alveoli will connect to form a mammary duct, okay, through this mammary tubules. So these are called as mammary tubules, and they will connect to form one mammary duct in each lobe. Clear? So I have also written the expanded part of it. You can see this is how the alveolus looks like, and this is nothing but the mammary tubule. So like this, from different lobes, different tubules from that particular mammary alveoli will combine to form a mammary duct. Okay, so like this, the mammary duct will be proceeding ahead, and then you can see the expanded part of it. Right here, the mammary duct is being expanded, and this region only we call it as ampulla. Clear? And this ampulla will again become narrow, and that duct we call it as lactiferous duct. So lacti basically refers to what? Milk. So ferrous means bearing, so milk bearing duct. Okay, and these many lactiferous ducts will combine, okay, and they will point out to be to reach at the nipple. Okay, and there is a region which is reddish brown or blackish in color, which surrounds this nipple, and that part you call it as areola. Right, and you can also see whatever I have written in red mark represents the fat tissue. Okay, so this fat tissue will be deposited around these mammary lobes. Okay, and this fat tissue deposition varies from one woman or one lady to another lady, and that deposition of fat in the breast depends on her hormones. Okay, I'll come to that topic later, like which all hormones are taking participation in the development and functionality of your breast. I'll explain that also later, but now you have to understand the structure of the mammary gland. So now let us understand how the milk gets secreted inside this alveolus. Okay, see, I have written already the expanded part of the alveolus. So this mammary alveolus is composed of the cuboidal cells. Okay, it is composed of the cuboidal cells, and you can also see the nucleus is at the basal region. And if you remember, in the tissues chapter we have already discussed that when cuboidal cells, right, fold inwards, they will be having main function in the part of secretion, right? They become a glandular tissue, correct? So here these cuboidal cells will be responsible for the secretion of milk. Okay, so all these cells here will be secreting the milk, and it will be kept in the lumen. Okay, or the cavity we can call. So the secreted milk from the cuboidal cells will be kept in this lumen or the cavity of the alveolus, and it will be sent through this mammary duct with the help of this mammary tubules. And then it goes to the ampulla, from ampulla to a lactiferous duct, and finally it will be sucked out by the baby. Clear? So it's very simple that the milk will be secreted mainly by this alveolus, or we call them as alveoli, right, from the different mammary lobes, and then it reaches the mammary duct through this mammary tubules, right? And these mammary duct will reach to a widened part, and that you call it as ampulla. And then the milk reaches to this narrow tubules called as lactiferous duct, and from lactiferous duct it will be sucked out by your baby. Is that clear? So now let us understand which all hormones are playing a very important role in the development and functioning of the breast. So now let us discuss about important hormones. The first one is the estrogen hormone, the second one is progesterone, the third one is prolactin, and the last one is oxytocin. So coming to the first hormone, which is estrogen, it plays a very important role in the development of this mammary tubules and this mammary duct. Also, it plays a very important role in the fat tissue deposition. Okay, I already explained you that the fat tissue deposition varies from one woman to another woman. So that's because of this hormone, which is estrogen. Okay, it regulates or it controls the deposition of the fat around these mammary lobes. right? And coming to the second hormone, which is progesterone, it plays a very important role in the development of this secretory portion, which is nothing but the alveolus portion, right? And this prolactin hormone plays a very important role in the synthesis of milk from this cuboidal cells. Okay, and the last hormone, which is oxytocin, helps in the ejection of milk from these ducts. Okay, so also you have to remember that the estrogen and progesterone hormone plays a very important role in puberty as well as during pregnancy. Okay, at both the times, the estrogen and progesterone hormone helps in the development of the breast tissue, nothing but it helps in the development of this mammary ducts, alveolus, right? Also, it helps in the deposition of fat around the mammary lobes during puberty as well as in the pregnancy, right? So that's all about the hormones, which plays a very important role in the development and functionality of this mammary glands. I hope you understood this concept, and if you have any doubts, please drop them in a comment section. And if you find this video useful, please like, share and subscribe to the channel. Do not forget to click on a bell icon. Thanks for watching.